Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. This episode's going to be a little bit different. I want to show you the customized C++ input device that I've been playing with. Get your thoughts on it. Now, before we get going with this episode, I do want to call your attention to the fact that I will be giving a two-day best practices workshop at NDC Tech Town in Kongsberg, Norway, in September of 2023. And I plan to be giving another version of this best practices class at CBPCon in October in Aurora, Colorado. So I know that there are many of you who have contacted me over the years asking for small group, one-on-one kind of training things, which don't tend to work out very well. So this is your opportunity if you are in Europe or North America to attend one of my workshops. So be sure to check those out. Okay, so what I have here is an Adafruit macro pad, and I covered this briefly when I talked about my small collection of Python-enabled devices a couple of months ago on a not very well-received episode. This episode is not about Python, it is about C++ in a way. So I've got this keyboard, and you can see here on the display, it currently says C++ mode. If I toggle this encoder wheel, then I get it to say DaVinci mode here. Now, the reason I originally got this was to make my life of editing videos easier. So I wanted a few shortcuts for things like previous and next edit, select previous, select next, select all, select none. And you can see here that I have a handful of the keys configured to these things. They are ordered 0, 1, 2, 3. That makes this 5, and then 8, and then 11. So the bottom right one is select none, and 9 and 10, previous and next. And these basically just come down to up arrow, down arrow kinds of things. So you can see I can move left and right here, and I can move up and down here, and I can select all, select none with these. Anyhow, you get the idea. I may have gotten the order of the keys slightly out of order. When I'm using this for editing, I tend to just use these two for left and right and up and down arrows. So I've kind of gotten those into my muscle memory. Well, I thought, you know what? I've been programming in C++ for a long time, and I find myself typing things like const, constexpr, const init, no discard, no except, void, virtual, whatever. I find myself typing these things all the time, and I was wondering if it might be possible to have a easier time at inputting all of these keywords. And I have a device that can do that. So let's see where we can get. So as you can see here, if I'm in C++ mode, then I'm going to have a different set of conditions that I am checking for. Oh, and by the way, I have this little environmental sensor here that I've been playing with. So that's just outputting things on the screen all the time about the current relative humidity and temperature. Now, this is right outside my laptop's vent, which is why it's registering around 100 degrees Fahrenheit. All right, so let's see what we can do. Now, if you didn't watch any of my previous episodes about these Python-enabled devices, all I have to do is save, and the device automatically reloads, reboots with the current running code on it. Now, I have just a couple more things to add here, and then we will give this a test. But I will leave those for a surprise, and I will not show you what they are until the last moment. Okay, let's go ahead and give our bespoke C++ keyboard a test. Now, if you're paying attention, on the left-hand column here, I have all of my const keywords. So const const expr, const eval, and const init. And then on the right hand side, I have common attribute-y like things. No discard, maybe unused, no accept, and static. And in the middle column, I have auto, and at the bottom, double colons. These are things that tend to get used an awful lot. If I really wanted to, I could do something like static const expr auto, but that doesn't work great because I don't have spaces between these. Let's do a quick update. Okay, device rebooted. Let's try that one more time. So const auto, there we go. I'm gonna do that fairly often. Const expr auto, that looks good. And then if I've got something that I know needs to live in a one location for the lifetime of the program, I could do static const expr auto. There we go. All right. And I think that's looking pretty good. Now, if I wanted to write a function declaration, then I might do something like no discard const expr auto func something or another, whatever, no accept. And this is going to be common enough. If you look at code for me, then I'm going to go ahead and tell you that that's what these middle two buttons are that I have not yet mentioned. I've got the nuclear function declaration option. So a single press for no discard const expr auto func no accept. And in the case that it is one that returns a void value, then I've got const expr void func no accept. Well, so there we go. I hope you thought this little silly episode about my bespoke C++ input device was fun. I will plausibly actually attempt to use this in some upcoming episodes. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe.